Greetings, this is Simba Amani, representing the Shash Amani Sunrise, and I'm welcoming you to join us as we reach out and give forward to children in rural settlements and inner cities. Always remember, a pencil goes a long way.
My name is Richard Morse. I'm a musician in the band Ram, and I perform here in Haiti most of the year. Make music for the Haitian people.
Tell me about a little bit of your background and your geography. Situate me about how you.
I was. My father's American. My mother's Haitian. My father was a professor of Latin American studies at Yale University and other universities. That's where I grew up. My mother is a dancer, singer, performer. She runs a school now. I have followed my mother's footsteps because she used to sing songs, traditional songs of Haiti, voodoo songs, and that's what I do. At a certain point, I realized that singing songs wasn't enough, and so when I had free time, I try and help people with rural development, or try and go into the marketplaces to clean it up, create systems to improve the lives of the people who I call the unrepresented.
Okay. And what obstacles do you have to face? You know, following the path you have. You mentioned earlier in the interview.
Well. Music is a tough field. Originally, I wanted to do music, become world famous and all this. But eventually, I realized that I like making music in Haiti for Haitian people. So my goals changed. Several years ago, the earthquake hit us. That changed even more, realizing that singing songs wasn't necessarily enough. Sometimes you have to actually go out into the countryside and see if you can help solve problems. Talking to peasants or walking down the street talking to people is usually the best way to find out not only what's wrong, but perhaps give you ideas of how to fix things.
Good. And you mentioned a couple of development goals that you feel connected to. You mentioned farming.
Yes, I work with farmers. I work with farmers mostly. And that's just an integrated society project because you have infrastructure, you have water issues, so there's river issues, so there's irrigation issues, there's drinking water issues, there's road issues, schooling issues, health clinics. So saying you have a farmer doesn't just mean finding fertilizer or something. It often means that you have to pull a lot of different sectors of the government or of the international communities together to work and solve problems.
And Shash Amani works in schools. And so we try to support schools and the communities in which they exist, trying to make sure that our intervention is sustainable. Can you describe some of the things that you were mentioned about?
Well, I talked to someone who builds schools also, and one, first of all, sometimes they'll have primary schools and they often don't have secondary schools. So that's something to consider. Another thing to consider is that the education that an urban dweller will need is not necessarily the education that a rural student will need. So that's also something to take into consideration.
The programs you're describing. So what are programs?
So you would need. You might need irrigation programs. You might need agricultural programs. You might need soil programs, entrepreneurial programs, internet so that people can find markets. All these kinds of things that aren't necessarily what someone in the city might need. The other thing to consider is sustainability. How's the school going to be paid for? How are you going to provide teachers? How are you going to provide guest teachers? Whatever. I know someone that that is trying to build businesses next to the school to have the businesses pay for the school, whether it be chickens or whether it be Ben Stiller, who's an actor, an American actor.
You guys worked together before?
We just chat every once in a while. When he comes to Haiti, we try and hook up, and he tells me what he's doing.
Where are the schools that he's been?
He's working on a few schools. I believe he's doing this chicken project out in Leogat.
But where is that geographically?
To the west of Port-au-Prince. You know, Digicel has built a lot of schools. I remember they had a project to build 200 schools. I don't know how they make those schools sustainable. I don't know how they provide the schools with the right teachers. I don't really know. I know there's a university that they're trying to open. I don't know much about that, but I know that education.
That's through the Digicel Foundation.
Digicel Foundation, yes, is building 200 schools.
The company itself.
Okay. I don't know much about it. I don't know how they create the sustainability, or how they check on the curriculum, or to make sure that things are functioning as they
quality
should.
Control and
but I do believe strongly that the education of a rural inhabitant should not be the same as the education of someone living in the city.
Because of developmental reasons. I mean, you want them to be able to, when they graduate, become productive.
They have different needs.
Yeah, absolutely. And you actually have an interesting background. We talked off camera and you said that your mother is African Haitian and your dad is a white American. But you have the voodoo in you. Can you describe what that is? Maybe you should say it in the way you say it. Music is within you, is kind of what I'm saying.
I came here to research voodoo rhythms to make dance music. And originally that was my only intent, was the rhythm.
How long ago was that?
I came back in 85, so about 28 years ago. The rhythms don't walk alone.
Connect to the people. I came to hear a performance last night, and it was quite a riveting thing. I mean, I'm from Jamaica, and it was like reggae music for Haitians. I mean, you look a little bit like Bob Marley, you know, a white Bob Marley, a whitish Bob Marley.
Well, he was mixed race also.
Yeah, exactly.
Right. Mixed race people have a different perspective.
So you could be like, you could be like Haiti's Bob Marley, or Trinidad's Marshall Montana.
I'm Haiti's Ram.
Haiti's Ram, that's my man. So thank you, Haiti's Ram. We appreciate you taking the time to talk to us. Why don't you just give one little message for the kids who live in rural communities?
You always have a choice to do right, to do wrong, and always choose right. And believe in what you're doing, and don't give up.
Haiti's Ram, thank you very much. I really appreciate you taking the time.
Miami, when that I'm with you.